by, grab, use my toes, grab behind his leg, and my underhooks, I'm gonna pull him with my foot and my underhooks, and I'm gonna have his wrist, I wanna give him head position, this is very important. I give him head position, and I hop this foot to that foot, and I crawl go by. As I'm throwing and pulling, taking his body and going this way, and my lower body is going this way. Here, I lock my hands down that position. This works better for me than an underhook throw by, because regular underhook throw by, when I get this underhook in, the guy just plays down. If you get that head position on me, like I just right here, I can throw him by like a regular throw by. He's too strong. My arm isn't strong enough, but he's just blocking out the 30 bucks. I can't get it. Let me try to stop it, ready? Stop it. I can't get it, okay? Ready? I block the throw by. I get here, right here. It's harder block. Okay. Yeah, I have that extra leg, I'm pulling him. This is the other reason, that extra leg, that toe, falls from here. Even if he pulls his leg back and lands still behind his foot, I still have control of his leg. Here, come here. Even if he's fighting me hard, and I go to throw him by, the further away he is, the better this is. I get a 90 degree angle, and I pull him into me, I make sure I have to have this wrist. Give him that position, makes me feel comfortable. Here. When I pull, watch my toes slide down the back of the spool. It always ends up behind his leg. Here, here I am, single. It allows me to track using my body and my left leg. We're fine, this angle. He gets head position, butt out. I don't get to use my toe, I've got the back of his head, and I throw it up. Here. Now I've got it. One more time. So in, he gets head position, pulls his butt out, I have to have his wrist. Pull him in, make a step once, get my toe here, get my whole body thrown forward. Okay?